Hi guys, I'm Rich Wagon, a dad on a mission. So today I want to explain a little bit of the Not So Fashion Show, what it's about. But if you haven't seen the video that I explained a little bit of my journey called A Dad on a Mission, you check it out, it's a 30 minute video that kind of might give you an idea of who I am and all that. But anyways, the Not So Fashion Show. The reason I said Not So Fashion, I created this project, the Not So Fashion, is because I went through a deep transformation the last 2 years, like really intense, where I started to really go deep on who I am and why I do certain things and all that. And on this search, I started to realize I'm not about fashion. And if you look at it, the meaning of fashion is gonna say, like I just put it in here, fashion meaning, then popular trends, especially in styles of dress, ornaments, or manners of behavior. Then, or it can be a manner of doing something. So I realized, you know, like I started to look back in my life, and then I gotta try to be quick here, but thing is, when I look back in my life, for example, it started like at a really age, really early age. For example, when I grew up in Brazil, and if you ask me to play soccer, I don't know how to play soccer, okay? Which is sounds weird, because most Brazilian people know how to play soccer even well. And when people were playing soccer, I was playing basketball. Same thing with skateboard. I started skateboarding at a really young age. But when I started skateboarding, it was like the beginning of the skateboard movement. And everybody saw as like almost a bad thing. That's why they had, on that time, they had stickers, skateboard is not a crime. Same thing with when it came to religion. I went to a Catholic school. And at one point, I started to debate with my professors. I was like, listen, Why I need to go to church to be in contact with God if God is everywhere? I was like, I can go surfing and be in contact with God. And I don't need to be donating money to church to be in contact with God or to save my place in heaven. And they never really had an answer. And then they started to say like, oh, you're high, you're on drugs. I was like, what? The other thing that is unfashionable about me is the fact that I never had a problem hiding my emotions. In fact, you know, like I cried a lot, and when I was a kid, this was the song that they sang to me all the time.
Don't cry.
You know, like another thing that is unfashionable about me is that I was a vegan, and all of a sudden I felt the need to eat meat again, and I fought that that mentality that I had, and I started eating meat again, and I started feeling good again. Not only that, but the musics that I liked it. For example, like as a kid, I never really liked like kid songs. I was already listening to Iron Maiden and punk rock and all that stuff. I was always considered radical. It's like, oh my God, you're too radical. And you know, like, I was like, for me, I never understood it. Like, okay, I'm radical for reaching my goals, and I'm radical about my health. Like those things I don't see as radical, you know, like, and if you think about it, like eating real food and eating well and feeling good is not radical. Radical for me is actually going to McDonald's and eating crap and feeling like crap. So I started to, like, you know, like the last few years, I started to realize that. But, you know, a lot of the things that I, you know, people claim I was radical, it actually, it worked. and not only work for me to achieve my goals and other stuff that I wanted to achieve, but also like a lot of those things are being backed up by science now, you know, like, and a lot of that, it's not mainstream, it's still an emerging science and things like that. So my point was like, okay, first of all, like, why I'm being radical if I set up a goal and, you know, like, I understand a lot of my goals were crazy, because if you think about it, somebody that is 260 pounds is smoking two packs of cigarettes for at least I smoke for almost 6 years, you know, nonstop. It's not a whole lot of smoking, but it still damaged your lungs, 6 years of pretty much two packs of cigarettes a day. And then that person comes to you and say, you know what, I'm gonna be a triathlete and I'm gonna live off of that. It's like, if you think about it, it's insane. And I want to say insane, but it's crazy, you know, like it's a crazy goal. But I put that goal in my mind, and yes, technically, according with a lot of people, I was radical about it, but I achieved it. You know, I achieved it. I went from 260 pounds to a 6% body fat. You know, I didn't win Kona, or I didn't win a major in Ironman, but I won a bunch of local races. So that's my whole point, you know. Like, then lately I started to realize of like, okay, life is not about fashion, you know. It's the not so, that's why it's the not so fashion. And then the part of the show, okay, I put a show because I believe everybody, they can be the main character of their life. So life for me is a show, you running your show. But the problem is a lot of people just give that power away, you know, like they just follow the mass instead of actually following their truth. And that's what it's all about, you know, like it's finding your truth, it's finding your happiness, whatever comes to your life, you know, whatever happens, it's a choice, you know, like, so you can choose to be the main character of your life, or you can choose to be to just be somebody that is in the show but is not the main guy and just following it. So that's what everything is all about, you know, like that's why I put it the not so fashion show, because I believe that life is not about fashion. Life is about like following up your biggest, craziest dreams and making it through. It's taking responsibility for your life and being the main character for it. There's a right and a wrong way. Sorry if I don't feel it.